In this video, I will show you how to make that simple and practical inverter from scratch. Step by step in the details. This is a newly made PCB for the square wave generator. It was DIY made and manufactured by JLC PCB. All loose parts here will be soldered on this empty PCB. The most of them are the used ones. Their values required, printed on the PCB. The parts have been soldered on the PCB. This is a 6K ohms resistor, made by three various values resistors combined. The circuits diagram is showed, with an ICCD4047 chip used, which has 14 pins, soldered on the PCB. There is a LED indicator with its 6K ohms resistor connected to, between 12V positive and negative. The 12V positive is red wire. And negative or ground is the black wire. Number 11 and 10 from the chip are connected to a pair of dark gray wires. From number 11 and 10 combined output is the square wave. And its frequency calculation formula is here. A capacitor and resistors values are chosen as showed. This is a potentiometer for the frequency adjustment, just over there. A frequency meter has been connected to the one of the dark gray wires, either number 11 or 10. The black wire connected to the battery's negative already. Connecting the red wire to the battery's positive. The LED is on, and 55 Hz indicated. To adjust the frequency to 50 Hz. Turning the potentiometer clockwise. Just about here. 50 Hz has been showed by the meter. This is the way to do it. To change the meter's hook to the other dark gray wire, which is the one of the output terminals from the device. It is the same frequency as the other dark gray wire previously, that should be. The output of the waveform combined is the square wave like the one here. This is a DIY made, center tap transformer from a microwave oven transformer recycled. A multimeter's AC position has been selected and its probes hooked to the transformer's output. Switch the AC power on. The transformer's output is 10.3 volt, indicated by the multimeter. Changing the red hooker to the other output terminal now. 10.3 volt indicated by the meter. That is good. Incidentally, the input power is AC 240 volts. Switch the power off now. These are four MOSFETs of IRF3205, pre-soldered together as two pair of each side along bare copper wires. Each gate of MOSFET has a 22 ohms resistor attached. This U-shaped wire is the ground and soldered to the source pins of all MOSFETs. This is a heatsink for a pair of MOSFETs of IRF3205. And another one for another pair of MOSFETs. A device for the square wave generator, explained earlier. A capacitor with 2200 μF capacity. A DIY made 3-pin socket with its bracket for the load of the output. A 30 amperes fuse with its bracket. A DIY made switch, which will control the square wave generator. A DIY made heavy duty wires. A pair of the battery cables and alligators. All parts and components will be connected and secured on a board. All done. Everything is secured by screwed on a board. The connection diagram for the parts or components is here. To start with the battery, which its cables and alligators are secured on the board. A 30 amperes fuse, which is located here, and the one of its ends connected to the positive battery cable. That rectangle thing is the square wave generator, which is secured between two heat sink on the board. A 2200 μF capacitor is secured here on the board. Incidentally, that capacitor needs 25 volt at least. The switch, which controls the square wave generator, is secured here. That switch is one of the pins connected to the battery's positive, the other pin connected to the square wave generator's red wire. The square wave generator's black wire connected to the battery's negative cable, which, where the cable is secured. A pair of the wires for the square wave generator's output is dark gray in color, each of them connected to the gate pins on each side of two MOSFETs bolted on the heatsink. As you've known, two MOSFETs connected in parallel for their pins corresponded on each side. Plus, their drain pins bolted on the heatsink, which means the heatsink is their drain pins on each side. This DIY transformer's primary for this project is center tapped coils, each of them has 12 turns. The twist wires are the center tapped terminal, which connected to the other end of the 30 amperes fuse. The other terminal, such as the one from the low part of the transformer's primary terminal, bolted on the bottom of the heatsink. The one from top part of the transformer's primary terminal, bolted on the top of the heatsink. The transformer's secondary terminal is the output, which connected to the 3-pin socket for the load. A multimeter's probes hooked to the output terminals and selected to AC position. The output socket has been plugged into a home appliance such as a bulb. A 12-volt battery is there, and connecting it now. Turn the switch on. Without a bulb on, AC 209 volt indicated by the multimeter. Now switching a bulb on. The output voltage is the same as AC 209 volt, with a load. Turn the switch off. Now the output socket has been plugged into a multi-socket set, which has been not only plugged into a 18-watt fan. But also a bulb as before. Plus a mini oscilloscope has been connected to the output terminals. To connect the battery, then turn the switch on. The output waveform is showing on the mini oscilloscope. It is not square wave anymore. It looks like the one here, which is sine wave, but not a perfect one. All good. That's how to make your own simple, practical DC 12-volt to AC 220-volt inverter, which can drive the common home appliances such as a fan, bulbs and recharging phone, etc. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.